Welcome to the video, friends. It is Medical Cosmos and we are going to learn about how to count anterior ribs and the posterior ribs today. And it is very essential part of the chest x-ray. When we look at this, we need to identify the number of ribs which are seen anteriorly and which are seen posteriorly to identify various pathology. Now, just to give you a to the point description, first of all, to identify first rib, it is very easy. You can see this flattened rib, which is very sloping down downwards, and just posterior to clavicle. This is clavicle, as you can see. This is clavicle, and just intersecting posteriorly, passing downwards below the first rib. We have with us the first rib. You can see it clearly. Now it's very easy to identify. Now when we identify second rib, we need to just to look more carefully, closely. As you can see here, this is first, this is the anterior end of first rib. Then we have anterior end of second rib. The ribs which are, we know that bones are opaque, opacities seen on x-ray. They are not lucency, as you can see. Lucent areas are lung area, which are generally lucent, as but please don't think that it is normal x-ray. It is abnormal x-ray, but this x-ray is used for educational purpose to get you know the how to count the ribs. This we have the second anterior rib going below. Then we, if we see more carefully here, we can see the third anterior rib here. You may see it, third anterior rib. Then fourth anterior rib, you can see it clearly, the margins. Then fifth anterior rib. Okay, now to normal x-ray, we expect 5 to 7 anterior ends of ribs seen below the diaphragm in mid clavicular line. Just count that in your memory. Now just to give you a quick review, this is first rib, this is first rib, this is clavicle, first rib. Then we have below it second rib. You can see that there is a lot of space between them because due to x-ray refractory properties. This is first rib, this is second rib, this is third, this is fourth, and this is fifth. This how we count the anterior ribs. It's very simple. Now when we count the posterior ribs, it's sort of a difficult part, but it will be easy now. Okay, now when you see the first rib clearly here, originating from here, you can just see the below. Obviously the below part would be second rib. There is no rocket science that. Now it is second rib. Now just see the curve of second rib. It comes like this. This is the second rib which we counted. Alright, this is the second rib. And below second, obviously after 2 comes 3. Now it will be 3. There is no rocket science in this also. 3, we come like this. Now this is 3. You can easily, now when you count this 3 here, and when we have already counted 3 here, we can easily make out the curve of this, which is often very difficult. Now below 3, just see more carefully. 3, below 3, this is 3rd. Obviously this would be 4th. No rocket science is that. Likewise, it would be 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, then 10. You can see the 10th rib also. So this is the basic phenomena, and this is basic criteria according to which I grade, I count the ribs. I hope this helped you. Now just to review on other side, we can see it clearly, more clearly, because the it is relatively clear than the left side. Now this is the first rib. You can see it clearly, very broad, slowly sloping downwards, first rib. This is the second rib. See the second rib. This is the third rib. Third rib. Second, which is coming like this. First, then we have fourth, then we have fifth. All right. Now to count the posterior rib, this is first. First. This is second, coming like that. This is third, coming like that. Fourth, fifth, then sixth, and so on. So this was the basic the basic understanding of counting of ribs, and I hope that it helped you, and keep tuned for more videos. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.